Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with the HPE ProLiant DL325 Gen11 server. And you know what that means? A new processor. At full capacity, it can support up to 3 terabytes of memory. Features a single AMD EPYC 9004 series processor for some pretty incredible core counts and a single processor that can take the place of a dual socket server. At up to 96 physical cores, it has the goods to do just that. HPE says this flexible little server is edge optimized and can be used for low cost virtualization, software defined compute workloads, or a content delivery network. We have reviewed the earlier Gen 10 version and you can see that video here. That one was powered by a single second gen AMD EPYC. And I know what you're thinking, did it ever support the third generation AMD EPYC? Nope, that would be the DL325 Gen 10 plus V2 server. Yeah, we did that one too, right here. Anyways, back to our current system with a fourth generation AMD EPYC 9004 series CPU. It supports DDR5 memory, PCI 5.0, 12 memory channel architecture, and can be outfitted with EDSF drives. Those are definitely some of the highlights. It can also support 2 single-width or 2 double-width GPUs. The front panel supports several storage conditions depending on the drive backplane that's installed. Drive support includes SAS, SATA, and NVMe storage devices, but only SAS or SATA for the LFF option. There's also an optional bezel that goes with this system that looks like it's branded for an X-Men data center or something. Maybe Wolverine does dual duties for Professor X as an administrator. An 8-bay 2.5-inch chassis can be converted to support 10 bays total. And then there's a 20 EDSFF E3.S 1T NVMe drive version. EDSFF drives are designed to replace the U.2, U.3 NVMe SSD form factor and provide the greatest storage density of all the options available on this system at up to 307 terabytes using 20 15.36 terabyte drives. I will add that if 2 single or dual width GPUs are added to the mix, then EDSFF drives are limited to 8. Only 4 SFF storage bays are supported with GPUs too. Of course we have this system in stock. For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system you can configure or one that's listed on our site at $5,000 or more. Yes, it's a sweet deal. The only thing you have to do is mention this video to save. For more information on this system, or to contact IT Creations, just click that link. No, we don't care where you are and there are no forms to fill out, unless you want a quote that is. Check it out, itcreations.com, or just click that link. GPUs listed in QuickSpecs include the NVIDIA A2 card featuring 16 gigabytes non-CEC acceleration. CEC refers to an external root of trust chip, but this one has it integrated. It is a PCI 4.0 low profile card with a x8 connector width that only draws about 40 to 60 watts of power. It provides software support for virtual applications, NVIDIA Virtual Workstation, NVIDIA AI Enterprise, and NVIDIA Virtual Compute Server. It offers a 20 times increase in inference performance through real-time endpoint sensors and cameras. It's an instant upgrade for modern AI applications. Beyond that, there are currently no other GPGPUs or GPUs listed for additional single-width or double-width cards, nor a wattage limit. So that's all I have on this topic, for now. I may add additional information in the description at a later date. AMD's fourth generation EPYC processors with 16 to 96 cores are supported with a thermal design power rating of up to 400 watts and up to 384 megabytes of L3 cache. A modifier on the end of the model number provides additional information. A P is for a single processor application, F for high frequency, and X for AMD's 3D V-cache technology, which is not supported on the system anyways. 6 memory module slots to either side provide 12 slots total. With all slots loaded with 256 gigabyte DDR5 registered memory modules, the system will provide up to 3 terabytes of memory, operating at a top speed of up to 4,800 megatransfers per second. Load-reduced DIMMs are not supported. In a nutshell, DDR5 memory modules have a higher base speed and draw less power than DDR4 modules. DDR5 memory modules provide a 50% increase in data rate transfers compared to DDR4, at least for these initial versions. More speed to come. The front of the 4 LFF bay version supports an optional optical drive on the right. There's also a serial number tag where you'll find ILO information, an optional USB 2.0 port, USB 3.2 Gen 1 port, and an ILO service port. Drives below with a control panel on the right server ear. That control panel is the same for the 8-bay 10-bay SFF chassis and EDSFF chassis. Both of those have an ILO service port and a USB 3.2 Gen 1 port stacked to the left of the control panel. A media bay in the upper right of the 8-bay chassis can be configured with the optional optical drive or two more optional storage bays for 10 drives total. The control panel features the power on button with integrated LED, a general health LED, NIC status LED, and a unit identifier button with integrated LED. On the back of the system, there are dual redundant PSUs on the right with options for 500 watt, 800 watt, and 1600 watt, all with a 94% power efficiency rating. Dual mezzanine card slots along the bottom are for Gen 3.0 cards supporting a number of connection options and leak speeds. Between those OCP slots, dual USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, an integrated lights out management port, and an optional serial port. A VGA port is squeezed in between the PSU and OCP card slot. Above all that, two PCI slots with a space in between that can be outfitted with an HPE NS204i-U Gen 11 NVMe hot plug boot optimized storage device. That little unit supports dual 480GB M.2 NVMe SSDs and automatically creates a RAID 1 mirror for redundancy. It saves those upfront drives for more virtualized storage options and won't use up a PCIe slot. HPE Embedded Management includes the integrated Lights Out utility with intelligent provisioning. Connected to the network through that dedicated 1 gigabit Ethernet ILO management port allows administrators to manage the system from anywhere, securely. Depending on the version, it will help provision and manage the system in band or out of band and can be configured to send alerts. This particular platform has ILO 6 standard, but you can upgrade to ILO Advanced or Advanced Premium Security Edition, which offers more tools to manage the system. That would be for managing the single server. HPE OneView, on the other hand, is a one-to-many application and also comes in a standard version and advanced version. But advanced does require additional licensing as well. Once we pop the cover, you can see the two risers in back, each with a x16 PCI 5.0 slot and x16 connector width. The primary riser features a full-height, full-length slot, while the secondary riser can be either a low-profile or half-height, half-length slot. Although, if the hot plug boot-optimized storage device is selected, then a low-profile secondary riser is required and a cable kit. There is also an M.2 enablement kit, but that one doesn't provide hardware RAID support. Certain combinations with GPUs and OCP and or riser slots will also impact data bandwidth for the GPU, so keep that in mind. Those OCP card slots have a PCI 5.0 by 16 connector width, but by 8 bus width. A number of smart array controllers are supported on the system. Some can be installed in the PCI slots and others in one of those OCP mezzanine card slots, including the MR408IO Gen 11 storage controller with 8 lanes and 4 GB cache that we have installed on this system. That one fits in one of those OCP card slots. This HPE ProLiant DL325 Gen 11 server at 1U is a great way to add capacity to your existing network with a single processor platform that can perform the same as a dual processor system. With support for up to 96 physical cores and 192 virtual threads, the capacity is there for supporting virtualized workloads or simply providing more compute cores. If you're interested, check out itcreations.com. Or if you're looking for something else, we probably have that too. itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.